Good afternoon, friends. So we will go into the next concept in the resource management, that is equipment management. So generally in the civil or construction field, we generally use lot of equipment, maybe earth moving, maybe lifting equipment, maybe grading equipment, concrete production equipment. Okay, there are so many equipments we are using. So what are the management principles in managing these equipments? We'll see one by one. Okay, now if you see this statement, equipment, it is a common fact that we find a wide variety of construction machines, wide variety of construction machine, from earth moving to concreting equipments, lot of variety are there on every site of construction, which makes our job easy, safe, quicker. Easy means the less difficult, safe means if labors are doing, a little bit safety is compromised there, and faster in construction. Good project management in construction must vigorously pursue the efficient utilization of labor, material, equipment. Means what? If you are having a project management system in your company, then you should utilize the three components. What are these? Labor, material, equipment. All the three components should be efficiently used. The use of new equipment and innovative methods has made possible changes in construction technology in recent decades. Means what? Whenever some new equipment is manufactured and new method is researched, new method is developed, those things has made possible changes in technology. Means the new methods, new machines have made changes in the construction itself. The selection of appropriate type and size of construction equipment often affects the required amount of time and the effort, thus job site productivity or a project. Okay, so the equipment size and equipment type generally affects the time required for the completion. So the equipment is directly related to the time used for construction and effort, both way it is possible, and thus productivity is also changed as the project is also completed earliest time. Okay, these equipment act as backbone in the case of huge construction project. Okay, in major projects, mega engineering or civil engineering or irrigation project, these acts as backbone. What equipments? Okay, proper use and appropriate equipment contributes to economy as well as quality as well as safety, speed and timely completion of the project. So equipment directly contributes to the economy, quality, safety, speed of construction. Okay, equipments are used for highway projects, irrigation projects, building projects, power projects, water supply project, nuclear projects. So many projects are there in each and every construction type, so equipments are inevitably using. Okay, almost 15-30% of the total project cost has been accounted towards equipment and machinery. Okay, in the previous only labor composition 15-30, material composition 50-60, so remaining machinery, equipment, generally remaining 15-30%. So it is therefore important for site managers, it's very important for site managers and planners, construction planners, to be familiar with the characteristics of major types of equipment most commonly used in construction. What should be they knowing? So the main characteristics of equipment type, whether it is a diesel run, petrol run, what is it is moving in time, moving out time, cycle time, okay, completion required, what is its speed, what is its operating cost. So each and every characteristics should be well known by whom? Site managers and construction planners. Why? Because its cost is included in the project itself. Okay, that's why these are very important. Contribution and importance of equipment. What is the contribution? Okay, in major projects, the speed of work, timely completion work is very important. Okay, major projects, it's time bound projects, so the speed and timely completion is very important. The proper use of equipment contributes to economy, so the same points, quality, safety, speedy and timely completion. Okay, so the proper use of equipment relates to these four basic points. What are those? Economy, quality, safety, speedy and timely completion. The cost of equipment in engineering project ranges to 25 to 40. In the previous way, we told that 15 to 30, that is old data. Nowadays, mega projects generally go for equipment only. So that is why the total cost of equipment share is 25 to 40%. Okay. The amount which is invested in purchase of equipment should be recovered during the useful period of such equipment. So if you 20 lakhs is invested in equipment, so 20 lakhs of amount has to be completed by that equipment. Okay, when? During the successful useful period, during the recovered during the useful period of equipment. That is generally 5 to 10 years. Okay, in that one only it has to be recovered. Okay, advantages. What are advantages of utilizing these equipment? Can you name anyone? Eliminate the heavy manual work by human, thus reducing fatigue. Means if labors are continuously used, they go for fatigue, tiredness, but machines will not get tired. Okay, so eliminate various other hazards. Maybe in some cases labors are used, some smoke, fog, everything will be there, so only operator can take the precaution and do the work without getting harm. Okay, but if full labors are employed, so they may get exposed to these hazard situation as well as exposed to health issues. Maintain high quality standard often required by present day design and specification. Nowadays, high quality products are required, but labor intensive work cannot produce the high quality product, but equipment can produce the high quality. Increase in rate of output through the work progress. Obviously, compared to the labors, equipments are more speedy in construction with the best effective and efficient methods. That is the very, very important. Okay. Carry out the activities which cannot be done manually. Carry out the activities which cannot be done manually, or to do them more economically, much faster. Equipment generally do the work very fast and economical compared to the human labor. Maintain the planned rate of production. Obviously, the production rate is depending upon the how speed you can do. So, skilled labor, unskilled labor are not there, then you can go for equipments directly. Reduce the overall construction cost, especially for large contracts, because big contracts generally labor intensive work is not possible. So that is why they are going to for purchase or hire of the equipment, so they will reduce the cost by continuously operating. Okay, classification. How the classification of equipment is done? Okay, depending upon the application, construction machines are classified into various category. What are those? Okay, application, earth moving equipment, these are generally used to move the earth. Okay, earth compacting, in road work you can have to compact the earth, in dam, so their compaction is required. Hauling equipment, concrete from batching plant has to be transported to the site. Hoisting equipment, from the ground level to the third floor, from the ground level to the 15th floor, so the equipment needs to be utilized for transporting or hoisting the equipment. Conveying, there is a large, big, lengthy area, so convey from one side to another side, we require equipment. Aggregate production, what we call in crushers and all, these are used for to produce the aggregates. Okay, equipment used in concrete construction. Can you name any one equipment? Batching plant, concrete mixer, vibrator, surface vibrator, leveling instrument. Okay, so all those equipments can be used. Pile driving instrument. Pile driving are utilized where the soil SBC is very, very less, so deep foundations are required, where we go for pile driving equipment. They use pile drives to get the pile work done. Okay. So can you see this figure? Earth moving equipment. In the earth moving equipment, there are a lot of categories. Okay. Payloader, backhoe, dozer. Okay. Okay. Logging equipment, hydraulic excavator, scraper. There are so many equipments that are used for the earth moving operations. Okay. Earth moving equipment, the selection of earth moving equipment is mainly depending upon following factors. What are the factors? Okay. quantities of materials to be moved. Depending upon how much quantity required, the selection of earth moving equipment is there. Okay, the available time to complete the work and the job condition, how much time is there? So small work is there, you go for smaller equipment, similarly for larger equipment. The prevailing soil types, okay, so whether it is a soil is poor nature, granular nature, depending upon that, swell, compaction factors, the equipment, earth moving equipment is selected. Okay, the job conditions include factors such as availability of loading and dumping area. Also the job conditions such as what? The loading and dumping area, so also important in selection. So site accessibility, traffic flows, weather conditions are also very important in selection of these. So examples, you can say earth moving equipments, excavators, backhoe, front shovel, dragline, clamshell, bulldozers, scrapers, graders, loaders, trenching machine. Okay, these are lot of equipment are there. Okay, so if you go to the previous one, these are the earth moving equipment.